Good job. So the mean should be the same as the population mean, and the standard error should be the population standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size, which is about 1.56. So remember, since these are the theoretical mean and standard error based on all possible samples of size 5 from this population, they probably won't get exactly the same standard error as what we found, but they should come pretty close. So let's see what they got.
The standard error of the mean, computed using this formula, derived from the central limit theorem, is sigma 3.49 divided by the square root of our sample size, 5. So that's 3.49 divided by the square root of 5, or n. That comes out to be roughly 1.56. If we took the true standard error of the mean, in other words, computed the actual standard deviation for all of the sample means we just took, that value is 1.57. Very, very close to that given by the formula. In checking the distribution of sample means, the sampling distribution of the mean here was approximately normal. Not perfectly normal, but pretty close. So all in all, we see the central limit theorem works and provides us a useful tool that we'll use for the rest of the semester. So hooray for the central limit theorem.